wanted to accompany him. So he had to go back, and at Kanaikant Shala, he met Rupa Sanatana Goswami and empowered them. After that, he came again, all alone. The day he arrived in Vrindavan, that was the Sharad Purnima day of Kartik, the day when we saw our Damodar Rath. At that time, this whole place was a big forest. Mahaprabhu used to stay in the night at Abdul Ghat, and during the day, he would come at Indikala. He would be completely absorbed in his in ecstatic mellows and thinking upon meditating, absorbed in the pastimes of Krishna. This is very nicely explained in Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. Since that time only, these Goswamis have been celebrating the arrival festival of Mahaprabhu. From Bengal also some Vaishnavas come here. There is a big festival, kirtan, and discussions of Mahaprabhu's glories. At their request, today we have also come here. I will explain briefly about Mahaprabhu's, the reasons of Mahaprabhu's coming to this world. Who is Mahaprabhu? Before, and what is his glory? So many different incarnations have come in this world. He is the embodiment of all the different incarnations that came before him. What is the reason for his coming? He is very, very merciful. If he would have not come, then people would have thought that the Supreme Lord only exists in his Aishwarya form, in the form of Narayana, and that he is the only worshipable deity and the ultimate truth, and that Krishna is actually a manifestation of Narayana. People would have thought this if Mahaprabhu would not have come. Therefore, to show his mercy to the people of this world, Mahaprabhu came to establish that the Supreme Lord also exists in his Madhurya form, that he tastes all the different rasas, and he is the aspect, he is the vishay of all those rasas. He could have also tasted all these mellows in Golokham. Then why did he come here? For the purpose, the reason he enacted his pastimes in this world was that the people could meditate upon those pastimes, and slowly, slowly, meditating upon them and becoming purified, they would ultimately become qualified to enter into the pastimes of Krishna.
So, if Krishna had not come, not Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had not Krishna gets to Krishna, you would have seen that how that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God, and he has all analysis, especially six arguments. But Krishna wanted to show that in love and devotion, I can be shunned of. I can be friend of anyone. Also I can be beloved. And thus I will serve them, my beloved, and my parents also, my friends also. If Krishna has not been generous in this world, in that Supreme of Personality of God has been so popular. Son of the beloved of all the devotees like this. So by mercy Krishna showed it is that I am son of God, I am friend of God, I am beloved of anyone, and I may be also beloved of. So to show this thing, I think Krishna chanted and did this much, especially Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Thank you.
So, Krishna Katha is Krishna himself. Those who hear these Kathas with great Shraddha, with great faith, slowly, slowly all the unwanted desires, the anarthas, go away, and bhakti manifests within their heart, and finally they are able to enter in the pastimes of the Supreme Lord. Krishna is Rato Vaisara. He is the ocean of all the rasas. Still, even being the ocean of all the rasas, he manifested these pastimes and tasted the five rasas. He is the Vishaya of the five fellows, Dasya, Sakya, Shant, Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya and Madhurya. Still, there was something that he was feeling missing within his heart. Raja Pranay Mahima. He is a Jagat Guru and he thought that there is no one, I am the most beautiful. Seeing my beauty, the entire world gets enchanted. But who is that whose beauty I get enchanted? That is Srimati Radhika. I am the sweetest, but by whose sweetness I get also enchanted, that is Srimati Radhika. Hearing the sweet voice of my Venu, the world gets attracted. And similarly, hearing my sweet voice, the entire world gets enchanted. But hearing Radhika's sweet sound, my Venu also stops playing. And I also get overwhelmed. I am Padmapur Tattva. That is, there is no one greater than me. But here is this. This is a roundabout thought. This is a vichar, which is opposite. He thought that there is something within me, seeing which Radhika is enchanted. I get enchanted by her, but there must be something within me by which Radhika also gets enchanted. And she reaches the highest platform of Unmad and Param Vaikuntha. What is that sweetness halfway within me, because of which Radharani reaches that level, I am not able to understand. But there must be something within me, and the only way I can understand that is if by mercifully she gives me her heart, so that I can understand what is within me which attracts her. Then Maharaj said that there were two other reasons for Mahaprabhu's arrival in this world. Second one is Saruna, that he is very, very merciful. Krishna. The service to Krishna is our goal. Our prayer, our goal is neither Radha nor Krishna, but the love that is between Radha and the love that Radha has for Krishna, that is our goal. The love that makes both Radha and Krishna dance, that controls both of them, that enchanted by that love, Krishna also forgets who am I, and Radharani also forgets who she is. So this love is our goal. For to give this love only, Mahaprabhu came to this world to give this Rag, Anurag and Mahabhav to explain all these moons, to give all these moons to the people of this world, to establish the process of Rag. But this is still a secondary reason. The primary reason is still Radha Pranay Mahima, to understand the glories of Radha Pranay Bhav. Maharaj said that to understand this, we'll have to take another word, Radha Pranay Vikram Kalarani. I worship that form of Krishna. I worship Mahaprabhu, who is Krishna himself. She is a vikar of Krishna's pranay. Now the word vikar in Hindi is sometimes taken in a negative sense. That it is sometimes when something goes bad, for example some vegetables goes bad, then that is called vikar. But that is not the meaning here. This can be taken as a are having a more superior transformation. So that's why the vikara, the transformation of prana is even superior to prana itself. Just like when milk is transformed into form of rasgulla or sandesh, its value increases. Narayan is saying that in Vrindavan there is something called khurjan, which is sold, and it is much more expensive than milk. Similarly, the transformation of prana, which is rapa herself, is superior to prana also. She is Vrishbhanu Nandini and she gives pleasure to Krishna, by which Krishna also gets control, becomes controlled by her and worships her. In order to relish all these moods, Mahaprabhu came here, but just like that he was not able to relish. He first had to go to the school of Vishakha and Lalita and get trained. And where was the school? At on the banks of Godavari. He discussed these matters, he asked questions from Radharaman and was able to understand all these subject matters. Then when he was in Kalkira, he manifested all these transcendental meadows. Radharani also came to the form of Gadadhar Pandit, and she would always observe that Mahaprabhu, who has come taking her mood, if he is making any mistake in relishing her moods, and when he would make a mistake, she would, she in the form of Gadadhar Pandit would correct him. And so I worship that Mahaprabhu. Now another question arises, that who came first? Did Mahaprabhu manifest first because he is Radha and Krishna combined, or Radha and Krishna separately, they exist first? So Maharaj is saying, both of them are simultaneously the absolute truth. They both exist simultaneously at the same time. If there is, for manifestation, they are one in the form of Mahaprabhu, and for enacting their pastimes, they become two as Radha and Krishna, and Krishna himself is Mahaprabhu.
हम लोग का समय पूरा हो गया है, अभी वहाँ 6 बजे से हम लोग का प्रोग्राम चालू होने का है। आज ओडिशा की सांस्कृतिक प्रोग्राम होना है, महाराज लोगों की कविता भी होनी है, तो इसलिए संक्षेप में दो एक बातें बताता हूँ। कृष्णा से कुछ महापुण्य का राधा जी से भी महापुण्य का क्या हो गया साधारण राधा कृष्ण दोनों पीड़ित है, इसलिए दोनों की मर्जी, दोनों की कृपा पीड़ित है, इसलिए महाप्रभु ने जगत से ऊपर की कृपा करके जो कृपा की राधा और कृष्ण अलग अलग होते हैं। कृष्ण ने रसा का आस्वादन किया, यहाँ तक कि दाताओं को भी प्रेम दिया, ये बात ठीक है, किंतु प्रेम को भाव कर कमाने पर एक छठा एक विधान सुधारती नहीं के जैसा मात्र बदल थे काम बदल गया, जो जैसा जिस रूप में हमारा भजन करता है मैं दिन का उसी रूप में संविधान करता हूँ, किन्तु चेतन आप रूप का ऐसा नहीं। कृष्ण प्रेम आइए जहां दूर दर्शन एवं दयाल प्रभु नाही त्रिभुवन है कृष्ण प्रेम जाना था। राधा कृष्ण जी जदपि ये ईश्वर आश्रय की परावर्ती है, यह बात ठीक है, किंतु यह परावर्ती और भी आगे बढ़ जाती है महाप्रभु के रूप में श्री सचिदानंद ने जो कृपा किया कृष्ण जी को बताओ कैसे कांग्रेस किया भजन कर दिया, महाप्रभु ने किया स्वयं पात्र भी दिया और पात्र देकर के पात्र संसार में प्रेम कर दिया, कृष्ण नामे आगे अपराध कर दिया, कृष्ण नामे और कृष्ण अपराध कर दिया है, चेतन नहीं किया आनंद है नाम ले लेते हैं बड़े अच्छा जो सामने आ जाएगा उसे वो प्रेम चाहे बाल खा हुआ है और जा रहे हैं महापुरु की गाड़ी खंड से बस से और उनके बोली को उनके पैरों के स्पर्श से बाल खालू और हाथी भी कृष्ण कृष्ण का ऐसा ध्यान को ये लोग बड़े करके नहीं पात्रता भी प्रदान करते हैं अपराधों को दूर भी कर देते हैं पात्र भी देते हैं अपना साथ में ऐसे ही देते हैं इसीलिए इनका भाव आएगा कृष्ण ने राम राम नहीं किया मैंने एक भाव नहीं किया मना सोचा उसी हाथ का वो प्रभाव अभी समय नहीं घटने के कारण से मैं सबके मां के मन के भाव किया ये सभी भाव से भी जीवों के लिए और भी उनके परिवार से रूप पर जाने के लिए ईश्वर बृहद व्याख्या करके और जीवों को ईश्वर दे दिया उन्होंने महाप्रभु के संदेश में खुद पर ही बनी भक्ति दशा में सिंधु की हम समझते हैं कि जो भारत में भी जो जीत विषय का देवी की जो कला है वो भारत है उसे भी सुरक्षा दादर करते हैं ये कलाएं हैं कुछ है सरकार में दादर सर्व तरीके से नाम के माध्यम से नाम कीर्तन के माध्यम से इस प्रेम को यही नहीं सारे विश्व में जो किया जैसे पृथ्वी से जब आगे नगर आगे नाम सर्वत्र प्रचार पहले बनना आज उन्हीं की कृपा से हमारे आचार्य लोग पश्चात देशों में मांस मछली और गाय खाने वाले को मांस और यात्रा करने वाले आज हरि नाम में सबसे लोग साधु लिखा है कुछ दिनों के बाद में श्वेतान देश के लोग और हमारे भारतीय लोग चोटी और गले के तुलसी माला लेकर के दोनों विषय के करेंगे क्या हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 यह महाशक्ति की बात है ऐसा है कि स्वामी दुर्ग भक्ति का भी प्रचार हो रहा है स्वामी जी की कृपा से पिता प्रभुपाद के शिष्य गए और हमारे गुरु जी से संन्यास लेकर के गए और सारे विश्व उनके जाने के बाद उनका वो मिशन कुछ सिद्धि हो गया आज हम हमारे जैसे पीर को जिसमें कोई योग्यता है और सारे विश्व को भेज करके इस प्रेम को ये महापुरुष जी की कृपा का होता है इसलिए उस महापुरुष जी की हम वंदना करते हैं विशेष करके एक और है कृष्ण ने मारा लोगों को पशुओं को मारा कैसे मारा चक्र से मारा और किसी से मार करके हाथ से किसी को मारा किसी का गला दबा दिया किसी का कुछ किया वे लोग ये नहीं समझते उस जन्म में नहीं समझे हमारी मूर्ति देवी या हमको उतना ही जन्म में नहीं समझ सकी कि आपको गुरु वृंदावन में मातृ महापुरी ने किया जगाई मताई का उद्धार और इतने लोग उद्धार किया प्रेम प्रधान के हृदय को परिवर्तन कर दिया और लोगों ने किसी जन्म में देखा जो इसकी अनुभूति ये कृष्ण विद्या में ये महापुरुष जी के महापुरुष इसलिए महान प्रभु पहले प्रभु के भी प्रभु दो प्रभु नित्यानंद प्रभु और थे और इन प्रभु के भी प्रभु इसलिए के महान नित्यानंद प्रभु कौन है भव्य प्रभु जी कौन है आप लोग जानते हैं ये कौन है और इनके प्रभु के भी ये प्रभु इसलिए महान संसार में प्रभु कौन है सबसे क्योंकि कृष्ण प्रेम दे सकता है इसलिए ये विश्वंभर होकर विश्वंभर से कृष्ण प्रेम का दान करने के लिए है ऐसा कृष्ण जी इसके लिए रचा दान के लिए विषय होकर गया है और ये विषय आज जरूर मिल सके इसलिए ये महान प्रभु है ये विश्वानंद प्रभु श्री बलदेव जी है और सदा जी ये दोनों प्रभु है इन दोनों प्रभु के भी प्रभु ये
स्वीकार करना, इसलिए ये वहां चलो भैया कृष्ण ने मंदिर भाव ले लिया। महाप्रभु ने क्या किया? तो इस तरह से उन्होंने किया और एक और अर्थात तो वो प्रकाश किसने किया? राधा तो क्या राम के संभाग में विश्व को बताया कृष्ण का आ रहा है, कृष्ण और राधा की आ रहा है। राधे कौन है? ये प्रेम प्रयोग है। यदि राधा कृष्ण मिल भी जाए और प्रेम न रहे तो हम पान सब जरासंधर और राजों की बात करें और कृष्ण प्रेम से कृष्ण अपने आप पशी पुत्र है, नारायण पशी पुत्र है, ईश्वरी का प्रेमी और कहता है महामुनि सर्व सर्व महात्मा से विश्व में किस प्रकार से सर्व रूप में सरल रूप में जो कुछ भी कहते हैं उनके अंदर में भी तीन भावों को जगत में विचार किया ऐसे महामुरु जी ये महामुरु जी सबके चरणों में पुनः प्रणाम करते हैं और हमारी प्रवृत्ति ये भूमिका करें। ये गुरुनाथ जी पद्मनाथ जी विशेष हम लोगों के सत्य है कि हम लोग कक्षा पर आह्वान किया, निमंत्रित किया और हम लोग को सुझोग दिया ये उनके सम्बन्ध ये हमसे अधिक विद्वान है और सब प्रकार से सत्यों को जानने को है तभी हमको उत्साहित करने के लिए उन्होंने ऐसा आयोजन किया और जब हम थोड़ा सा प्रचार करें इसमें
जारी
were given in a very easy way by Mahaprabhu.
he said, as a result, several of the prachar boy about them, he said, one day, all over the world, my holy name will be chanted. And Sri Bhaktivinoda Thakur also said that one day will come when people in the Western world also giving up their sinful activities will embrace this Vaishnava religion. And we are seeing today that today, all over the world, this is spreading. And Swamiji, who was a very beloved disciple of Sri Prabhupada, he spread this message all over the world. But after he left, it slowly became this slackened after he left. And Maharaj, in a very humble mood, is saying that I am fools. As though as a straw of grass and very unqualified, by His mercy, I am also doing some service by spreading this message. Another thing is that Krishna, He killed the demons, whether by His chakra or by strangulating someone like Putana. But in that life, those demons were not able to understand what their final destination was. After being killed by Krishna, what was their journey? For example, when Putana was killed, in that life she was not able to understand what gati she has obtained, what destination she has obtained. They could not realize the mercy of Krishna in the same life. But in the case of Mahaprabhu, the people he delivered in the same lifetime, they were able to realize his mercy like Gakai and Mathai. Also, what is Mahaprabhu? Mahaprabhu means Mahan Prabhu, the great Lord. He is the Lord of Lords. He is the Lord of Nityananda and Advaita. Who is Nityananda? Balev, Lord of Day. And Advaita is Shiva, Sadashiva, or Mahavishnu. And Mahaprabhu is the Lord of all of them. And therefore he is called Mahaprabhu. Maharaj also said another thing, that person is called Mahaprabhu who gives love to the entire world in the greatest fashion. And this was meant by Mahaprabhu, and that's why he is called Mahaprabhu. That's why he was also called Vishwambhar. Krishna did not give Manjali Bhav, but Mahaprabhu came, and he also manifested the Ramanand world. In his conversations with Ramanand, he clarified all the subject matters. That who is our Arabya? Our Arabya, as Maharaj explained before, is the love between Radha and Krishna. Even if we may attain Radha and Krishna, but if we don't have that love, then we are as good as Kans or Jarasans. And that's why the love between them is more important. By attaining that love, Krishna also can be controlled. Mahaprabhu, in a very simple manner, explained these things and gave this name to the entire world. We pray again and again at His lotus feet that He kindly be merciful upon us, and we also pray to the very respected Sri Padmanabha Goswami for inviting us. Actually, we don't have any qualification, but by inviting us and giving us an opportunity to speak, He is encouraging us to spread this message all over the world. God bless you.
All are waiting here. So Bhagwanji is so very there. And also Ram is there. He is there.
Where?
Oh, Rama. Oh,
Rama.
Yeah. Rama.
Rama.